Mr. Satya, see, first of all, what I'll suggest is whenever you are doing congruency, at least when you are starting congruency, always ride the four rules first. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So, you know, initially it becomes very confusing that which rule has to be applied. Whether this has to be applied or this to be applied, this to be applied, this to be applied. So I always suggest that you write all the four rules, yeah, in the rough work. So for example, if this is your page where you are doing your question, on the rough hand side, you write these four rules. Mr. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So write the four rules because we don't know which rule will be applicable. So this is the first thing. The second thing that you need to do is, whenever you are doing congruency, just separate the triangles which are being discussed. What that means is that in this question, what we need to prove is that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABD. So what I'll do is, I'll separate these two triangles. How do I do that? ABC. And just, I will draw a rough diagram. I won't draw a very, you know, a very neat diagram. I will just draw a rough diagram. Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So I have drawn these two triangles which I want to prove whether they are congruent or not. Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then I will look at the data which is available. What is the data which is available? The data that is available is that AC is equal to AD. So what I know is that this AC is equal to this AD. Satya, do we agree to this?
Yes, sir.
The second thing that we know is that AB bisects angle A. What this means is that this line AB, this bisects this angle. What this means is that this angle would be equal to this angle. Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
What this means is that this angle would be equal to this angle. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Now these AB and AB, AB and AB, they are the common sides. They are the common sides. Therefore, they have to be equal. Satya, any doubt?
No, sir.
So therefore, this side would be equal to this side. Satya, have you understood? Is it making sense?
Yes.
So
yes.
Now, when you look at what you have done. You have said that this side is equal to this side. You have said that this angle is equal to this angle. You have said that this side is equal to this side. So, Mr. Satya, which rule would be applicable?
Sir, SAS.
Out of these, SAS. Sarthak, is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
See, Mr. Sarthak. So congruency, first you will have to understand the logic, and then of course you will have to write the answer. Now usually what I have seen teachers do is they make two columns. So for example, they will write AC is equal to AD. Now this is, they will write the reason on the right side. This is given. Angle CAB is equal to angle DAB. Now this is also given. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Or if you want to explain, you can say that AB is a bisector of angle CAD. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
AB is equal to AB, common side. So you have a S, you have a you have a S. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABD. The rule applicable is SAS. Sarthak, any doubt?
No, sir.
So I like this style where they make two columns. Here, they will state something. So this would be the statement, and in the right hand side they will give the reason. And once they have given the reason SAS, they will finally proclaim that the triangles are congruent. Satya, is it making sense now?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Sarthak, is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
So let me take another example. Or what you can do is you can try this question. Just try to do this question, following the step that we have discussed. Just try this question and we'll discuss. Yes, Mr. Satya, how did you do this?
Sir, AD and BC are equal. So, sir, I think that this is RHS because there is like they are perpendicular to each other.
Okay.
So, like AD and BC are perpendicular to each other. So that's right. And sir, it is right angle, sir. Because of that, I think it is RHS.
Okay. Mr. Sarthak, what do you think?
So I couldn't understand the question.
Okay. So how do we do this? The first step that we follow is we focus on the triangle. So what they want is that show that CD bisects AB. Show that CD, this line CD bisects AB. So what do you want to prove? You want to prove that this line bisects AB. What this means is you want to prove that this side is equal to this side. Basically, what you want to prove is that OB is equal to OA. Sarthak, have you understood now?
Yes, so that I understood, but I don't know how to prove it.
So what do you think? Do you have any guesses? Can you guess anything? Well, geometry is all about logic. So if you want to get into, you know, coding, etc. Mr. Satya.
Yes, sir.
Do you want to get into coding?
No, sir.
You don't want to get into coding? Mr. Sarthak, do you want to get into coding?
Sir.
I'm sorry?
Not really.
Okay. So usually, if you want to get into coding, you require a lot of logic. You require a lot of logic, and geometry is the best way to build up your logic. Mr. Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So, if your geometry is good, basically what it implies is that your logic is good. If you want to improve your sense of logic, geometry is the best way. So, I have made these two triangles, and I want to prove that these triangles are congruent. Now, what is the information that I have? The information that I have is that BC is equal to AD. Mr. Sarthak, what is the reason? Mr. Satya, what is the reason?
So because like they are perpendicular, sir, like
it's given.
I don't know exactly.
Yeah. It is given. They are equal. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
It is given. This information is given. If you want to write, you can write the full line. Information is given. Or you can write this information is given. Whatever you want. Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Then, angle CBO is equal to angle, which angle? Angle
DAO.
DAO. Again, this is also given. Mr. Sarthak, do we agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any other thing that you see? Mr. Sarthak, Mr. Satya. This angle would be equal to this angle. Mr. Sarthak, what is the reason?
So because AB is being bisected by DC.
Mr. Satya.
So exactly.
Because they are vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Do we agree to this?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Sarthak, do we agree?
Yes, sir.
Now, on base of this information, we have this side which are equal. We have these two angles which are equal. We have this angle which is equal. So, what do you propose? Are these triangles congruent?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, Satya, what do you think?
Yes, sir.
Why, Mr. Sarthak?
So because there are two angles congruent and one side is also congruent.
So Satya, what do you think? Mr. Satya?
I think because both angles are congruent.
Okay. See, what you need to understand is this side should be the included side between these two angles. Sarthak, have you understood? Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So basically, the side that we are considering is this. Now, this angle is equal to this. These two angles are equal. In last lecture, what we understood was, if two angles are equal, then the third angle is automatically equal. Have you understood?
Yes,
sir.
Therefore, angle ACO is equal to angle ODA. Do we agree to this?
Yes.
I think, is it making sense or not?
Yes, it is.
So this angle, basically what I'm saying is that this angle BCO, what I have written, I think I have made a mistake. One second. Yeah. So what I'm saying is that this BCO, angle BCO, is equal to angle ADO, angle ADO. Is it making sense, ma'am? So now, if you look at the two triangles, I have this angle, I have this angle, I have this side, I have this angle. I have this angle, I have this side, I have this angle. So therefore, the two triangles are congruent, applying ASA. Sarthak, is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
Now, if these two triangles are congruent, then if you remember, we had discuss something called CPCT. What this says is corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Mr. Sarthak, do you remember?
Yes, sir.
So basically, what this means is that if this angle is equal to this angle, the corresponding sides would be equal. If this angle is equal to this angle, then this side would be equal to this side. And if this angle is equal to this angle, then the corresponding side would be the side which is opposite to this. And the side opposite to this angle would be this. Therefore, OB is equal to OA, and you will write by CPCT. Mr. Satya, has it made any sense?
Yes, sir.
So Sarthak, is it making any sense?
Yes, sir.
So basically, what you guys do is you try to figure out which triangles are being discussed. You separate the two triangles, you write the rules, and then by applying logic, you try to prove that the triangles are congruent. Mr. Satya, Mr. Sarthak, can you try to do question number 2?
Yes.
Yeah, just try using the things that we have discussed now. Mr. Satya?
Yes, sir.
You can start. Question number 2. ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AD is equal to BC. So we have given that AD is equal to BC. Okay. And angle DAB, this angle, angle DAB, this angle, is equal to angle CBA. Is equal to CBA. Yes. So these are the things which are given to us. Now we need to prove that ABD, this triangle, is congruent to triangle BAC. Satya, have you understood the problem?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the first step that you can do in all the questions, and that makes the question a bit easier to understand, is usually what I do is I separate the triangles. Because once I have separated the triangles, then I can see very clearly that what are the two triangles which are being talked about. So one triangle is DAB and the other triangle is ABC. These are the two triangles, and I draw a rough diagram just to put all the information that I have on that, on the two figures. So this side is equal to this side, this angle is equal to this angle, and of course AB and AB is common, therefore this would be equal. So is it making sense?
Yes.
Sarthak, is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
So are the triangles congruent, Sarthak?
Yes, sir, they're congruent.
So what is the rule?
So SES.
Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So see, once you have drawn the triangles and once you have placed the information on the triangles, then automatically you will start seeing the reasons. Satya, have you understood? Have I answered your query?
Yes, sir.
The first step to do is, first step when you are starting congruency, the first step is to write the four rules. The second step is to draw separate triangles. Step number 3 is put all the information on the triangles. And usually, by the time you finish these 3 steps, you will start to see the which result would be applicable. So we have done this. So Mr. Satya, BD is equal to AC. Why?
So because two of the sides of the triangles are equal, so third has to be equal.
But you'll have to say, see, basically you will write this CPCT. What does CPCT mean? Because I know that triangle 1 is congruent to triangle 2, and I know that this angle is equal to this angle, therefore the side which is opposite to this angle, which is a side, this side, which is a side opposite to this, it is this side. Therefore these two sides would be equal, and the reason would be corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Mr. Satya, is it making sense?
Yes, sir. So can you please repeat the full form of CPCT?
CPCT. Okay. What it means is congruent parts. I'm sorry, it says corresponding parts of congruent triangles. See, the important, there are two important words. First, you will have to prove that the triangles are congruent. So this is the CT means congruent triangles. Once you have proven that the congruent, that the two triangles are congruent, then you will have to look for the corresponding parts. So let us see, let us try to understand again what do corresponding parts mean. So let me explain it to you again. So for example, now once I have proven that these two triangles are congruent, yeah, so I know that this angle is equal to this angle, therefore what is the side which is opposite to this? BD is the side. Which is the side which is opposite to this angle? It is AC. Therefore BD is equal to AC, and the reason would be CPCT. Satya, is it making sense now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let us try to understand this further. Now if you look at the triangles again, this side is equal to this side. Now which is the angle opposite to this side? This is the angle. Therefore this angle would be equal to this side is equal to this angle is in front of this angle is in front of this. Therefore this angle would be equal to this angle. Satak, is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, these two angles are equal now. So this angle is equal to this. This angle is equal to this. Which is the remaining angle? The remaining angle is this. Therefore, this would be equal to this. So is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
So that is why when you look at the third part, ABD, ABD and BAC, BAC. Again, these would be equal. The reason would be CPCT. Is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
See, what I'm trying to tell you is that let us assume that we have these two triangles, triangle ABC and angle XYZ. Yeah. Now, let us assume that you have proven these two triangles are congruent by applying, ASA. Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Let us start with the assumption that these two triangles are congruent. Yeah. Once I have said that these triangles are congruent, then I will start looking at the corresponding parts, because I have proven that these two triangles are congruent. Now, what will be the corresponding parts? Let us try to understand that again. This angle is opposite to this angle. The side opposite to this is BC. Therefore, BC would be equal to XZ. So, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
This angle is equal to this angle. This side is opposite to this angle. And this side is opposite to this angle. Therefore, YZ would be equal to AC. Sarthak, is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
Now, this side is equal to this side. This angle is opposite to this. And this angle is opposite to this. Therefore, this angle would be equal to this. Now, have you guys understood the meaning of CPCT?
Yes.
CPCT will imply that XZ is equal to BC, that YZ would be equal to AC, that XY would be equal to AP. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
And similarly, BAC, Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes.
Would be equal to XYZ ABC would be equal to YXZ. No, have I made a mistake? BAC. This was a single one. This was a single one. BAC would be equal to the single one. XYZ. Yeah, this is okay. Now I'm taking the double one. Double one is ABC. This would be equal to the double one, which will be YXZ. YXZ. And the last is the single one. Single one is this one. So angle ACB would be equal to angle, single one is XYZ. यार मैं गलती तो नहीं कर रहा हूँ.
But XZY.
Yeah, XZY. I'm sorry. Yeah, XZY. So this is what is called CPCT. Have you guys understood?
Yes.
So basically, CPCT implies. So what CPCT implies is that equal angles have equal sides opposite to them in congruent triangles. Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
I'll repeat. CPCT implies equal sides have equal angles opposite to them. Now this happens in congruent triangles. You can also write this as equal angles have equal sides opposite to them. And this means corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Satya, is it okay?
Yes.
See, CPCT. It is also written as, it is written as corresponding parts of congruent triangles. It is also written as congruent parts of congruent triangles. Both of them are same. Have you understood the logic? Satya, Sarthak?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, we'll do one more question, I think. Then you can do few more questions as homework. I'll send you this file. We'll do another simple question. Try to do question number 5. Yes, Mr. Sarthak, how to do this?
So the first part, right?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. So APB, so it's a right angle, and line AL is common between the triangles. Sorry, AB is common between the triangles. So that will be the same. And then angle BAP and angle QAB are the same. So it will be so the two triangles will be congruent by ASA congruence.
So Satya, what do you think? मिस्टर सत्या, सत्या है भाग्य। So, Charlie, this is given. These two are 90 degrees, so they are given. We have this side, which is equal to this side. And then, L is a bisector of angle A. So, this angle is equal to this angle. Now, we have discussed before. I am not able to hear you. So, this angle is equal to this angle, this angle is equal to this angle, therefore this angle would be equal to this angle. Sarthak, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
So the triangles are congruent, we can apply ASA. Is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. Now, once we have done with this, we know that we have that CPCT. Using CPCT, I know that if this angle is equal to this angle, then this side is equal to this side. Perfect. Is it making sense? Yeah. Yeah. And that is what we need to prove, that BP is equal to BQ. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah?
Yes, I understand.
You want to do another question? Mr. Sarthak.
Okay, sir.
Actually, what you can do is, I'll send you the scan of this. Can you note this now? Just try to do question number 6, question number 7, question number 8. These are the questions that you'll be able to do. You'll have to apply a bit of logic. Question 4. So I'll send you this PDF. Just try to do these questions. And you know, the basic thing that you need to understand is write the rules first. Keep looking at the rules. Always, whenever you have to prove any two congruent triangles, just make the triangles separate. Then, as per the information given, start applying the information on the figure. So they might say this side is equal to this, this side is equal to this, this angle is equal to this. So start, you know, jotting it down on the figure. Usually once you have reached this stage, so this is the stage 1, this is the stage 2. By the time you are able to do stage 2, usually you'll be able to see that what is the rule which is applicable. And by stage 4, in mostly all the questions, if you apply CPCT, so usually in this question, the first part is prove that this triangle is congruent to this triangle. And usually the second and third part is that on the basis of CPCT, you'll be able to do part 2 and part 3. Sarthak, is it making sense? Sarthak, is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
So let's meet the next time. You can do these questions as homework, Satya. And again, what I'll suggest is just have a look at this video again, so that you know if you have missed anything, you can go through that again. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.